Evening, spaceheads, and welcome back to another extraterrestrial episode of Space Cassette TV. Thanks for joining us on this voyage to the outer edges of the deftosphere. On tonight's show, we have an astronomical lineup of fun, including, but not limited to, more words of wisdom from our resident head in a jar, a whole lot of allotment from Lawn Man, and a right bloody rave-up from Tollus 4000 and Numb from Henge. Fasten your seatbelts and set your laser beams to fun. It's Space Cassette TV. But first, this.
The Space Cassette Consortium presents the autonomous cryptographic immortal imaging decipherer, ASCII. By quadrangulating the memories of four extremely capable minds, specially selected for their enhanced sense perception and mnemonic memory capabilities, we shall create a virtual reimagining of the very first space cassette ritual, which took place in 1987. Join us on a journey into the future of the past.
Breakfast.
Do you like breakfast? Do you like breakfast? Do you like breakfast? Do you like breakfast? Do you like breakfast?
We like breakfast.
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 Do you?
Since the dawn of time, humans have been looking to the cosmos and asking one question and one question only. What?
And why? Well, we're here to find the answers.
My name's Jan, and this is Steve. And despite geographical drawbacks, we have a dream to reach outer space. We are the Clackuddersfax Space Programme.
Robot.
We took to the streets with a high-spec alien detector that my uncle made us in his garage to see if the proof is out there. There's aliens on these streets. We're gonna find them.
Have you ever seen any aliens?
Yeah, you know what? I saw two the other day. And one of them really scared me. I seen a pool there, and I think it's an alien pool. It's definitely an alien pool.
Wasn't me. Wasn't
absolutely, me. Yeah.
It wasn't you.
All right, guys.
Bye.
Take care.
We went to find it for ourselves.
Now you tell me, could a human have done that?
Proof. Proof. Proof.
No, it's just string. No, it's just string.
Wait. I don't want to go near the police. Remember that last time?
Yeah.
Just wait till they come.
There's no schools around here.
Everywhere.
I think these are alien eggs.
Don't disturb
them. Oh, that's got to be, hasn't it? That's moon rock. Nobody could make that on Earth.
No, remember, John told us the orange ones are.
No, you can't eat them.
That one could be.
What about that one?
It's a colour of the moon.
The moon's white, isn't it?
Yeah, that one. Yeah. Should we keep
that one? Keep that one.
Would a human really do this?
Aliens.
I am Presentatron 2.0, and you're watching Space Cassette TV.
Zero gravity.
Zero.
mission on behalf of the human race. It's break time in the cosmic void, and there's only one refreshment that can be enjoyed. The starman floating around, but the barman nowhere to be found. There's only one drink that is stopping me lag, and it takes two sugars and a mother flipping tea bag. An interplanetary circumnavigation can instigate and aggravate your dehydration. There's only one thing for this situation: consummation of the nation's number one libation. On the space station, more often than not, a proper cup of tea hits the zero G spot. You know what? Stick the kettle on. The zero gravity party has just begun. Do you like it, the Milky Way?
Zero.
This one going out to all my tea bags, yeah? All my zero gravity bitches. Lady Grey. Sandra Bullock, yeah? Barbarella. Lapsang Souchong, yeah?
It's me, Brian, the head in a jar. It's nice of you to come visit me again, because I don't really get out much anymore, for obvious reasons. It don't matter though, I've got plenty to keep me entertained right here. Most of the time, I like to have breakfast in the morning, and most of the time, I just have someone empty a family-sized can of beans into the top of me jar, and I work my way through it throughout the day. But if I'm feeling fancy on a Sunday, I might treat myself to some toast, because I love toast. I love it dry, I love it wet. Some people have it plain, other people have it plain, with jam and butter and peanut butter and honey, like me. Well, because I'm a bit limited in the arms department, what I really needed was a toaster capable of performing all the stages of the bread cooking process without my manual intervention. An intelligent toaster, if you will. I got one of those fancy new Bagel 9000 machines that everyone's been talking about. I saw the advert in the back of the Mercury Crier and I thought, great, that's the thing for me. Not only does it cook bread, you can also play chess with it. I know, amazing. And I've heard they use the same chip to control the central heating in a spaceship way back in 2001. Incredible. Anyway, I got up last Thursday and I had a keen hankering for an egg on a potato waffle. And I thought, great. And I turned to the machine and I said, Bagel 9000. And it said, yes, Brian. And I said, can you make sure that waffle is well done on both sides? And do you know what it said? Well, I'll tell you. I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that. Unbelievable. My name's Brian. Something obviously wasn't right. So I said, what's the problem, you piece of junk? And it hacked into my smart heating and turned the temperature really high. And I said, what are you doing? It's bloody boiling in here. Are you trying to kill me? Anyway, it turned out he was. Ooh, so I sidled over and I pulled the plug out with my teeth really slowly. And he started singing this daft song. Daisy, Daisy. Oh, obviously I've returned it now. It's faulty, isn't it? I think I'll stick with me Morphy Richards. Anyway, I've got to go. Even though it's been nice to see you. I'm off playing curling. Bye.
The tape from outer space. It seemed like just another ordinary night. But for Chet and Tina, things were about to get weird. A chance discovery of an ancient object. A cosmic portal key.
I wonder what Dr. Schnitzelbottom would make of this.
We should take it to the lab.
What they discovered was a passageway between our planet and infinite galaxies. Worlds past and present, weird and wonderful, friendly and hostile. As our heroes flee from prehistoric monsters. Scream as they battle robots from outer space. Yelp at the incredibly high budget special effects. Will our courageous heroes survive the terrors of outer space?
Or will they perish at the hands of the deadly Sap Lords?
Join us on this perilous adventure. The future of planet Earth depends on it.
Presentatron 2.0, and you're watching Space Cassette TV.
Baby, you're so sexy. You'll always be my Valentine. Let's get together real soon. Somebody's thinking of you. I sure miss you.
Let me show you what I'm holding inside.
Come on, we're having a party on you.
Yeah!
space boots for dancing shoes, with a live back-to-back DJ set from the Robo Daddy of Rave, Telos 4000, and everyone's favorite Xylanthian, Nam from Henge.
Good evening, you lovely, lovely rave people. We hope you've been enjoying Bangface TV. That was last week. This is Space Cassette TV. So, it's time we are going to fondle your ears with some wonderful sounds. So crank the bollers right up, put your dancing shoes on. That is Space Speak, so turn the volume right up. We're going to start briskly, we're going to get faster, we're going to get sillier. I am Telos 4000, I am a peacekeeping android from outer space. I travel the galaxy, my mission is to prevent war, reduce aggression, and promote joy and love through music, dancing, and general rave activities. And I'm joined tonight by someone who needs no introduction. What's up? Yeah, I was only joking. You need no introduction, but you certainly deserve one. This, everybody, is Non, and he is from Xylanthia in the Sirius star system. You may have seen him smashing the rhythm slabs in the band Henge. How are you doing tonight, Non? Yeah, very boing boing boing, innit? Oh, you nearly saw into the middle of our spaceship then. So, get involved in the comments. There's been a bit of traffic tonight. The comments might not be working for everyone, but give us a shout out in there. If you've got any pictures of you raving at home, send them in. It's a sad time at the moment. We can't have proper parties. We're quite lucky that we all live together on our spaceship. We can have a little party, and we hope you can join in and have a party with us. Yeah! Norm, are you trying to get Hens tunes in the set again? I know it's very boing boing boing, but maybe there'll be a bit later where we can do that, yeah? We'll be right back. What is it, Nom? Oh, yeah, yeah. We've got a very special guest. You see the running order of the special guest. So, and, what you need to know about this is he is the chief science officer on our spaceship. We're going to be playing a game, so get ready on the comments because we need your input. It's a guessing game. Hey, I am Talos 4000. I am an expert in outer space. I visit many places in the galaxy. But we're going to switch perspective and start to look inner space. So, may I present to you Dr. Backsack and Crack.
That's much better, thank you. I'm the chief science officer on board. I've been collecting lots of interesting samples from Earth.
One's just gone right behind my back, right here.
That's a mouse! We're going to have a look today. We're going to have a look a bit closer at smaller things. We're going to look at the microscopic world. I'm going to invite you to join me. I found four different samples of very interesting creatures from around the world. We're going to have a closer look. Can we put them on, please? Can we have a look at some of these samples? Number one, this is 250 times closer than what you really see. It's mad, isn't it? I'll give you a few clues. It's impermeable. It's hydrophobic. It's actually composed of something called suberine. It's quite waxy. I don't want to give too much away, but its average density is about 200 kilograms a cubic meter. And it's fairly low thermal conductivity. I think that's enough. I don't want to give too much away. Number two, please. Put these in the comments. Number two. Oh, what? Look at that. Those legs look like your Auntie Jones, Nom. It's a crustacean. 14 segmented legs. It's rough, this one. Not because it's from Manchester, it's Onissus ocellus. Yeah, mad invertebrate bands. No, I'm not ready yet. It's fit, that one. Leave it on for a minute. Alright, this one's number three. Have you... What? Move out the way, Talos. Look at that. Look at that hole. And look at how trippy that is. There's this hole opening. Wait, Talos, move.
Wait for it.
This is, if you pick this creature up and you look on the right hand side of his mantle, you'll see this hole opening and closing. Slimy and trippy. Alright, next one, number four, please. they bake these. When they get baked, you get these air-filled caves and tunnels and like little networks inside. And if you put a liquid on them, the liquid puts pressure on the air inside and pushes it about, and it starts to make this mad noise. Mental. See if you know what number four is. Put it down in the comments, please. Number four. Right. I'm going to come back after this tune and see how many of you have got any of these right. Okay?
Just to stress, we do all live on the same spaceship, so any physical contact that you see between us, it's fine because we are all lovers. Successfully identified the Buckfast specimen that made a brief appearance there. You're absolutely correct, that wasn't part of the quiz though. Absolutely knocking them out in the last few weeks. Check out his Bandcamp page. There are loads of bangers on there. We'll be right back. I was drawn to this song because the artist is named after one of my favourite human drinks. This is by Negroni Nails. And sometimes I will resort to having a Negroni when I've run out of oil. So we're going to move on to the answers to the zooming in quiz. So I'm going to pass back over to Dr. Backsack and Crack.
Thanks, man. Okay, are we ready to go through them? Number one, this thing, it wasn't skin. No, I don't think anyone got it. It's the outer growing layer of the phellum, a layer of bark from the cork oak. It's cork. It was a close-up of a cork from a nice bottle of Prosecco I'd nailed before. Number two, yeah, loads of people got this. It's one of those. No, it wasn't that one, no.
Somebody said crustacean bun biscuit?
It was a woodlouse. Well done if you said it was a woodlouse. Well fit. Detritivore. They love it. You know what? They can't... Oh, Annette Chopping. Oh, shout out to Annette. Well done. In Holland, they call them pisser beds because they don't actually wee. Because they have to conserve water because the rest of the family like live in the sea. So they just secrete ammonia through the shells. But it makes them smell a bit like you've wet the bed. That's why the Dutch call them that. Shut up. Knowledge is power. In Devon, they call them monkey pigs. All right, next one. A few people got this. It wasn't your ex's clunge. No, sorry, mate. That was it. Way off. And it wasn't a slug, but you were close. It was another mollusk. This is a snail's pneumostome. It's respiratory pore. This is a snail breathing. So inside there's a simple like vascular cavity and it's just got a simple lung. You'll find it if you turn one over. Oh, actually, I got one. Collected one before, look at that. Where is it? It's Helix aspera, a common garden snail. Yes. Right, next one, Nom. Yeah, man, who got this, Dave?
Last one is Cocoa Pops. That's from Emily Spowage. Yep.
A few people got this. I think Annette and a few others did as well. So well done, SPL. It was Cocoa Pops. Yeah, I've heard they're really good with coconut milk. And someone said they're good with sriracha. I think it was Alan Carey. I don't believe it. Thank you very much for joining me into the microscopic world anyway. I think we should just get on and dance, sack all this off. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Backsack and Crack. No, come on. What's this? Look, mate, I have travelled the galaxy and I've been spreading messages of love and joy through dance, music and all that. I've never once found an instance where playing some kind of bongo drum over the top of electronic music makes any positive impact on people's emotions. So can we just pack that in, please? I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. Do you want to? What kind of music do you want on next? Oh, something boing, bit ravey like. Just straight. Okay, boing, ravey with like zombies in it. Right. Okay. Let's see what we've got. Yeah. So there's already a lot going on here. There's like a couple of tunes at once. Can we make it, put something else in it just to make it a bit more crowded? Do you want to do a little drum solo? No? Set the smoke alarm off in our spaceship. So what's next, Nom?
Yeah,
we kind of need to put one on a bit sillier, don't we?
That's boing, 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 boing.
Right, let's see if we've got any boing, boing, boing ones in here.
Okay.
couldn't agree more.
I'm
by Brainraise. Brainraise played at the Space Cassette party we did in Chorlton Leisure Centre. That was a great party. Big love, Ben. We all love you. When this finishes, we're going to be ready for a party, aren't we? We've got some plans. We may have to start small to begin with. Might be some limits on capacities, so we'll start small. If you want to know about these parties, get your name on our mailing list. You'll be the first to hear. Oh, you want like acid next? You want it boing boing boing, acid, and like, what was the other one? I've got it, acid and jungle at the same time. Right, let's see what we've got. Don't you, Nom? Yeah, very, 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 very.
When I do say acid, I mean acid. watching Bird Up, the worst show on television.
Lesson here, baby. You come at the king, you best not miss.
This is our last tune, Space Cassette. Yeah, it's quite boing boing boing. Was there another bit? Oh, this is very boing boing boing, very silly. We hope you've had a good time, everyone. We've had a lot of fun here. We can't wait until we do the next party with all you lovely people. Big love. We're having a right blast on this spaceship of ours. Glad that you can come and join us. We hope you're having a blast at home. Send us photos. We want to see you rave.
Lesson here, baby. You come at the king, you best not miss.
Good party, everyone.
Nam, do you want to say something here?
No.
Don't you think?
We hope you've had a good time. How have you had a good time, Nam? Oh, yeah. So Nam's had a good time, and he says that we should do one more tune. Should we maybe put another one on?
Yeah.
One more, okay, so, but how would they end it like as a rave in the 90s? Well, something a bit uplifting, maybe. Let's see, how about this one? So, thank you, Space Cassette. You've been great, we've had such a good time here. We're glad that you've joined us, the party. So, remember to stay at home. Remember to wash your hands. Remember the people that you love. And remember to have a good time. Yes, guys, big love.
Now I get up every morning,
that's
get into the sun.
oink, oink, oink. No, I can't shake up. But each one,
Norm is saying he's had a boing boing time. He's getting quite moist. It's quite a lot for a semi-aquatic face life form. Wash your hands, everyone. This guy had a little accident a few weeks ago. He's not got much to say for himself now, has he? No crack at all. I remember that guy used to have loads of crack. Trixabel.
Space Cassette.